Hello everybody, today I'm going to teach you how to paint yellow flowers. This is a painting I made a few years ago of a yellow iris, and we're going to recreate it on a canvas of 30 by 30 centimeters. That's approximately 12 by 12 inch. This is the pencil drawing on the canvas, and I'll start with burnt umber to secure the drawing. Don't forget the bumblebee. It's a Bombus terrestris. And now it's time to start with the background. Just finish this bit for the bumblebee. For the background I use cadmium lemon yellow. Yellow is green and sap green, and a medium to speed up the drying process. As you can see, I work from light to darker tones because I want to catch the light in between the layers of paint. So that's why I start with lighter colors, and I'll build my background in several layers of paint. I use the paint quite thin, and I want to have a soft tone effect of the background. So it's a suggestion of there is something behind the flower, but you don't know what exactly. I always paint at the same time the sides of the canvas, because you're not sure if you're going to frame it. Well, at least you have the same color on the sides. So this was the first layer of the background, and for the second layer you have to wait at least 6 hours. Although I've used the speeding stuff to speed up the drying process, it takes at least half a day to dry out the oil paint. For the second layer for the background I use yellow ochre, yellowish green, and sap green. I also take the green parts of the flower, the first layer. I put some more burnt umber in the leaves of the yellow flower. Just a tiny bit. You also can start to bring in some more details and contrast. while you're roughly making the first details, you can also mix the burnt umber with yellow ochre. If you have noticed, I started for the background from light till dark, but the flower I start with the shade parts. So there I start with the darker parts and then work my way up to the lighter parts. So now you've done some detailing and brought in some contrast. It's time to wait again for the paint till it's really dry. Now we're using lemon yellow, titanium white and cadmium yellow. don't forget the bumblebee. Some white to correct in the lines, just to make them disappear. So what you're doing, you're correcting your brown lines, but you can also add highlights. Second layer of lemon yellow and cadmium yellow. I'm also mixing some white in the yellow paint for the, to make some parts lighter. And the bumblebee. Some more yellowish green and sap green for the stem of the flower. And now it's time for bringing on the details. I will put some yellow ochre over the burnt umber because I find this too dark. Also in this part here, and maybe a little bit here. So what I've done, I've made some more details and softened these parts, only this part of the painting. Here, for instance, I did some yellow ochre and some white here to make it more realistic. Here, for instance, also some ochre yellow, some white, and some lemon yellow. So what you're going to do, you're going to retouch your whole painting all the way like this, and then it will become more realistic. As you can see, white lines, and then I'll make them yellow again. also more details in the green parts. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and maybe you've learned something, and see you next time.